that's the whole CERN Stargate thing is getting ready to start up.
And
we
what's
also
your take,
are blending the
Tom, what's your take on that? Because again, my position, I don't think it's different than yours in this, but based on what I've been told, and I've shared this with even the Coast to Coast audience as well as my listeners, is when you're having intense amounts of power to generate this, that it takes to create, if you will, this vortex or this dimensional gate, I mean, there is, I can tell you this, from people I know in the past, there have been problems that have been introduced into CERN to keep it from going into full-scale power-up for the obvious reason. When people in the military, and I know you have your contacts, I have mine, they're unknown to me, mine are unknown to you, but the bottom line is that they're talking about the quintessential gate, and when you take the literal perimeter of the CERN collider, we're talking about what one general said, one hell of a gate, okay?
Yeah.
Now, is it your contention, and we're going to do this, you know, the next time we have a couple hours next week at convenience for pre-recorded, but the point is that where, in your opinion, does CERN fit into it at this time with all of the, let's say, hoopla, information, disinformation concerning it? But, I mean, there are a lot of people, smart people, that know this has got a, quote, spiritual implication. You're talking about the matter, the stuff of life, the stuff of creation.
Well, look, I believe, and I know we're going to run out of time here in a couple of minutes, but I believe that in fact...
We've got 9 minutes, by the
okay,
way.
Okay, 9 minutes. I believe that in fact, science, but in 9 minutes we can't talk about CERN, so we're going to have to discuss it next time, but let
sure.
me just quickly kind of abbreviate an answer to this question. I believe that in fact, science is poised to either open or begin taking the first steps toward opening our world to other dimensional knowledge. And that could include contact with other dimensional intelligence. Now, I think this will happen on different levels, but on the one hand, you do have these scientists here in Europe. They're at the forefront of the world's, you know, largest science experiment, scheduled to begin in a couple of weeks, actually, or less than that.
Yeah, I think it's about a week, barring the adjudication in the courts or
right. Lawsuits. Yeah. Well, okay. So at this, you know, this $10 billion large hadron collider, and they intend to recreate what had happened in their mind in the split second after the Big Bang. We're talking mind-bending science here, and some people predict that it's, you know, it's going to. Well, everybody I think is saying that it's going to shatter our existing theories of physics. Imagine that everything in his lifetime that Albert Einstein did for us in our knowledge of physics, this thing is going to do in a few minutes, especially with its connection to the supercomputers that we have now that are going to be interpreting that data. And so, we are on the good side, on the science side, on the non-theological side, we are prompting the discovery of new particles. The existence of the theoretical Higgs boson, the God particle, which is theorized, you know, to give mass to everything in the universe, even though it's never been discovered. It's never been observed, at least. That's why it's called the God particle. But even more exciting or interesting or spooky, this CERN collider is pretending to prove the existence of unknown dimensions, Steve.
Yes.
And in doing so, they say it's going to radically alter our understanding of the universe. Make no mistake about it, these scientists are looking for something specific that has to do with other dimensional reality. This could be the first baby step toward the discovery of the kind of dimensional reality that until now has only been speculated about. And those who may be there. It's been written about in fiction. It's been fictionalized in our sci-fi movies, but most of those movies are based on assumptions out of science that have a very strange, weird way of becoming reality, if you know what I mean.
Well, right. Yeah, I mean, you used it in the Ahriman Gate. You used it in your current book. I'm using it, and I put in, as you know, I wrote a script for Hollywood on, the Giants, Genesis 6, and the whole idea of the ability to project themselves into our, meaning they, the fallen angels, the ones that have been bound. Interesting, I was told by a high-ranking military official that, Steve, human beings, because of the original authority that God gave them on Earth, are the ones who are actively releasing that very entities that will ultimately consume them. And when he said consume them, I said, like, munch and crunch them for lunch. He said, absolutely. See, I think that when Joshua and Caleb went in the Promised Land, the Bible records that the land devoured its inhabitants. And would it have not been for God's mercy in love for his creation in binding these things and having his servants who walked in faith do it? The point is now, Tom, everything that's been, if you will, hidden is going to be made manifest. And people's entire way of looking at everything, even the visible realm that we see, is going to be altered, because we're getting hit with different forms of electromagnetic energy than we've ever had before. This is going to be basically science fiction in the raw, on steroids, and the very brain cells that we've been given and the way we've been trained to think are going to be blasted. We're going to be master blasted right out of our paradigms.
Well, think about that. And by the way, for the people listening to this show, or if they're listening to it on an MP3 download or something later on, this isn't just Tom Horn and Steve Quayle hypothecating about what this would mean. They're a nuclear physicist, and they've filed a lawsuit trying to stop this from occurring. And they're warning that, well, this thing could literally unleash world-gobbling black holes, or some other type of energy, if you will, that could finish us all off in a few seconds.
And we know that's not going to happen, but the entities, the non-human intelligence, they're going to basically have a slip-slide right into our very laps, and I think it's going to be, so startling, Tom, that the people that know their God shall be strong and do exploits, as the promise in Daniel. But I think when we deal with this stuff next week, we'll just go into much, much detail. I want to thank you. I'm sorry that I was just so tired after doing last night. I got to bed at 4:30 this morning, then had to wake up at about 6:30 to post some of the stories or get them to my webmaster, Holly Dale. So I'm just shot. But next week, at your convenience, we'll talk and we'll come on and we'll pre-record a two-hour.
Hey, Steve, if we can, let's just pick it up right there. We have a lot of territory we can cover.
Okie doke.
All right, Steve. I love you, man. Thank you.
Thank you. Bless you. Ladies and gentlemen, I consider this probably one of the most important shows I've ever done. I believe Tom was basically giving it to you like you need to hear it. You can either choose to accept or reject. Those of you that can't handle all this stuff and call yourselves Christians, please take to the living God, to the Lord Jesus in prayer, because, again, you will either basically be delivered through the power of God by the knowledge he's given you and your faith in the blood of Jesus and overcoming the powers of darkness, or you will succumb. The choice is yours. Choose ye this day who you're going to follow. And that, basically, would be my vote for the Lord Jesus Christ. Good night, everybody.